Hey y'all, this is Jamie. Welcome back to my channel. And in today's video, I am very excited to be trying out some Neutrogena products. They are new products, but this is also a new experience for me. I have never actually tried any Neutrogena color cosmetics. I have tried some of their skincare, but I have yet to try any of their color products, so I am very excited. I hope you are too. But before we get into that, make sure that you subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so you can be notified when I upload a new video every Wednesday and Saturday. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into this. So the other day, I was watching Allie Glynn's. As always, I don't know how many times I've mentioned her on my channel, but I was watching one of her videos and she tested out some new Neutrogena products that I thought seemed kind of right up my alley. So I thought I would see if I could find them and test them out myself. So these are new products from Neutrogena. They are in new packaging. They look like this, really kind of youthful, modern packaging. I'm really digging it. I got four new products. So they have a new tinted moisturizer. We have a liquid highlighter, a blush, and then a sheer lip oil. These products all seem to be very natural, kind of a more natural makeup day. That's kind of my speed. I like more of natural looking, sheer to light coverage makeup. So the first products that I have is the Protect and Tint Tinted Moisturizer Broad Spectrum SPF 30. I have the shade Fair to Light 20. There weren't that many shades. That, however, is pretty standard for a tinted moisturizer because it's not as full coverage, so you can kind of get away with not having like your exact shade, and it usually blends well. This has five shades. We have Ivory Fair 10. This is the second shade, Fair Light. Then they have Light Tan, Tan Medium, and then Medium Deep. As I was looking, the Fair to Light and Light Tan seemed very similar. I would say that they could do with having like a couple more darker shades because it seems like the first four shades are very similar and then all of a sudden you have like a really dark shade. I think if they could make like three or four more shades and just have them kind of in between the tan medium and medium deep, I think that would be perfect. This is Fair to Light 20. It comes like this. It comes in a squeeze tube. I forgot my mirror. Hold. Okay. I'm gonna get this gigantic mirror. Let's see. Ooh, don't need to see myself that magnified. So I think that because this is a tinted moisturizer, I'm just gonna go in with my hands. Oh, it's pretty thick. So I actually may have gotten more than I really need, but I got that much. We'll start with one hand because I actually think I got more than I need. So I think what I'm going to do is disperse the product with my hands and then maybe pat it out with my sponge. This is very, very sheer coverage. As you can see, that didn't really cover anything. See, I don't mind a sheer coverage foundation as long as it helps with evening my skin tone, because otherwise I just wouldn't put anything on my face. I guess maybe this would be good for the SPF. It is SPF 30. My mom and I were just talking recently and she was kind of telling me that when you have SPF that's in a foundation, you have to put on like a crap ton of that foundation for that SPF to actually be effective. So you shouldn't rely only on the SPF that's in your foundation or your tinted moisturizers as your sun protection. You should have something else, whether it's your moisturizer, a primer, or straight up sunscreen underneath your makeup. I'm gonna put a little bit more on and I am going to kind of pat it out and then I'm gonna grab my sponge and do it like that to see if we can get a little bit more coverage. So far, this is really only making my face kind of red and splotchy. I'm actually very surprised. I'm not a huge fan of this so far. Okay, so I waited around a few minutes after applying it to see if the redness in my face would go down. My face was looking very red and very splotchy. And now I do have very sensitive skin, and so even like just tapping it sometimes will make it turn red. But this just seems like something different. Like I'm getting little patches of redness instead of like my whole cheek turning red. And I still kind of have like big red splotches on my face. I am not very pleased with this so far. So far, it's definitely not providing flawless coverage for me, because even sheer coverage in some other products has evened out my complexion. And so you still see all of my freckles, you still see my natural skin peeking through, but it's taken away that redness because I have, you know, splotchy skin. That just is what happens. And so if I'm going to wear anything, I wear it so that I can even that out a little bit. If I'm putting something on, I want something that will do that. Otherwise, I just won't put anything on. Because honestly, my face right now, it looks a little bit worse right now than it did before I put this on. So to me, I would just kind of say, why should I even bother putting this on? Other than the added SPF. This was $8.47, so this was, I think, the most expensive thing I got, which makes sense. So far, I'm eh on this. Okay, so I did apply just a teeny tiny bit of concealer. I put on the NYX Dark Circle Concealer. Moving on to the next product that we have. This is the Cheeky Wink Flushed Blush, and it is in the shade First Crush. So this is what it looks like right here. It's a very pretty dark peach tint, and it's got a bit of a like gold reflective. It feels really, ooh. Feels nice. It feels very soft, and it's more like a cream finish. It's like a putty. I don't know if you can see that. I would think that you should apply this because of that texture. I would think it would go best on under powder or before you powder your face. I am gonna go ahead and grab that with my finger. That's pretty. I'm almost positive that this is the blush too. Sometimes I get a little confused whether it's the blush or my natural flesh that's coming through. I like that. It's a very natural looking flesh. Yeah, I think that would look really pretty just on the eyelids as well, which actually, I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Yay! I was afraid I wasn't gonna like anything. But I like that. It gives a nice little flush. It's called Flushed Blush. I really like this. I think it goes on really nice. It's a very pretty color. And this one was $6.47. It comes with 0.15 ounces. Also, that blush does come in two different shades. So the shade that I have right here is called First Crush. This is the lightest shade. The other one is a like dark berry shade called Boysenberry. So the next product that I have is called the Glow On Liquid Highlighter infused with vitamin E. Right here, I have the shade Supernova. So this one comes in three shades. So we have the lightest shade, which is Moonlight Galaxy. Then we have kind of a more gold shade, which is called Lunar Eclipse. And then this one right here is the more champagne shade, which is called Supernova. So for half an ounce, it is $7.37. So we are gonna go ahead and try this out. I'm very excited about it. It comes in a little squeezy tube. Basically, this looks the exact same as the moisturizer tube. It's just a little bit smaller. So I'm gonna take a little bit of that just with my fingers, and I'm gonna put that everywhere that I would put highlighter. Takes a little bit of time to blend that out. Now this does have, like if you get close enough, you can see little flecks of glitter, but it's actually very pretty. Yeah, so I like that. That gives a very pretty glow. It is a little more difficult to blend out than I thought it would be. So I used both my fingers and my sponge to blend it out. I like that. It's a very natural kind of glow from within look. Okay, I am back. I put on a little bit of makeup. So I added some bronzer to my crease. I put a little bit more of that blush on the lids. I put on some brow gel from Essence. I put on a little bit of bronzer on my cheeks from Rimmel, and I put a little bit more mascara. So I did have mascara on the entire video. I again am using my CoverGirl Lash Blast Active Mascara. Love it. So for the last product, this is a lip product. It is the Sheer Smooch Lip Oil infused with Camellia Seed Oil, Sunflower Seed Oil, and Jojoba Oil. This is in the shade Be Mine. I believe this was the lightest shade. There are four shades, so these are all kind of shades of pink. I decided to get the lightest one because I'm really searching for that perfect everyday, put it in my pocket, put it in my purse lip color, and I'm hoping that this is it. Oh my gosh, come on, Jamie. I can't decide if my hair looks like cute messy or just she needs to go to bed messy. This one was $7.37. Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. I love that. It's perfect because it's almost invisible. Clear. That's what I'm asking for. It's almost clear. And that's exactly what I've been looking for every day. It feels wonderful. Very excited about this. I really like it. It's very hydrating. We'll see how long it lasts. All right, so those are the four products that I got from Neutrogena. I really love the packaging. I think it's very cute. To kind of recap, the first thing I tried on was the Protect and Tint Tinted Moisturizer with SPF 30. A little bit of the redness has gone down since I put it on initially. But honestly, my face doesn't look much different. And I think the parts that look different is because of the other products that I applied. I don't know that this is necessarily worth it other than the little bit of sun protection. I would just put on some sunscreen on my face and that's that instead of something like this. Now I will continue to use it because I did buy it. But I don't know that I would necessarily say this is a must-have. The next product that I tried out was the blush. I love this blush. I think it added a nice natural flush to the cheeks. It's a really cool consistency. It's almost like a putty. I would actually recommend getting this, especially if you like kind of a more natural blush. Or for those days, especially around, you know, especially since we're coming up on the more warm months. I know a lot of people like to use more cream products in the spring and the summer. So I think that this is definitely a product that might come in handy. And then for the liquid highlighter, I also did really like this. I think it gives a really pretty natural glow to the face. It does have specks of glitter if you get really close that didn't quite sink into the skin. And it was a little more difficult to blend in than I thought it would be. It really does give a really pretty natural glow to the face. How many times can I say glow? It's called Glow On, so I think that gives me the liberty to say glow as many times as I want. I really liked it. I think it is well worth your purchase. And then for the last one, I think this is tied with the blush for my favorite products that I tried. It's very satisfying putting it on your lips. It feels very nice. It has a very nice consistency. It's not too oily and it's not too glossy. It's like that perfect in between. I love it. And then I would also recommend that if you purchase any of these products, do it from Walmart. Looking at my receipt against the Neutrogena website, all of the products that I got were at least $1, $1.50 cheaper when I bought them at Walmart than they are listed on their website. To save a few bucks, see if they're in your local Walmart. If not, see if they're online at Walmart. So that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. That really helps me a lot to know what y'all enjoy. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel before you leave. I am trying to hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of 2019. So yeah, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see y'all in my next video. Bye, y'all.